I'm here at the beautiful town of Versumer, looking at this nicely restored Sexton tank, which was placed there by Dr. Matthew Kiln, in the memory of his father, Major Robert Kiln, and the British troops who landed on Gold Beach. Behind the Sexton is another interesting device, and I presume the title of this video already gave it away what it is. But let's have a look at it anyway. During D-Day, a lot of clever inventions were used. Of course, the main one people will think of were the Hobart's Funnies. Like the DD tanks, you can also think about the specially made Centaur tanks, and I did an entire video about the Centaurs, have a look in the description or click the top right corner. These tanks were designed to perform specialist tasks and reinforce ground troops on D-Day. These vehicles were nicknamed Hobart's Funnies, after their inventor, Major General Sir Percy Hobart. They include the Duplex Drive tanks, Churchill avres, the Crab mine clearing tanks, and the bobbin carpet layer tank. Another one of these inventions that would have been used by these tanks was a device called the Porpoise ammunition sledge. This British designed ammunition sledge was mainly conceived after the fear that the assaulting tanks would run out of ammunition. The sledge was there in order for the assaulting tanks to carry extra ammunition during the landings. This all before actual supplies made it to the landing beaches. Two versions of this sledge were designed, one for the Centaur tanks and one designed to be used with the main tanks like the Sherman and the Churchill. It could also be used with the M7 Priest. These sledges would have been waterproof for when it would have been submerged, and it could carry as much ammunition for the main gun and machine guns as what was stowed in the tank. The porpoises were designed to fit exactly under the designated tanks, so they could be loaded in landing craft by the vehicles themselves with a 15-foot chain. The tank would drive over the sledge and it would be fitted with two tow bars to the back. These two tow bars were fitted with an explosive quick release mechanism, which could release the sledge on command. Sadly, it's hard to find any combat reports on how they actually performed during the landings. So back here in Versumer with this nicely restored example, which was recovered from a Normandy hatch in 2011, was restored in 2012 and placed here behind the Sexton. When you first look at it, you won't think much about it, but this unique piece is presumably one of the only surviving examples. You would think that restoring a rare piece like this would come with some restoration difficulties, but it turned out that during restoration that getting parts for the sledge was fairly easy because a lot of farmers had collected the doors for the sledges after the battle. So there is a possibility that maybe in the future a complete one will be discovered in someone's barn. But now you would probably think, but why would they let a rare piece like this rust away outside? To that I would like to point you to Exhibit 1, this nicely restored Sexton, which hasn't been restored since 1999 and has no rust whatsoever. So the porpoise will be in good hands, and you will not see any real rust for the next 20 years. And I also get a lot of comments saying that you need to keep vehicles inside because of rust. And I sometimes like to point out this Sexton, and that it is possible to keep a vehicle outside without rusting, even in extreme conditions like salty sea air, like here in Versumer. But if you look at these vehicles either in great condition or rusting away outside somewhere and others being restored, it really lets you think about what people can do these days and back then. That these vehicles in this park are just a really small fraction. That men had overcome so much that they could offload so much equipment in a few days on D-Day. That you yourself are just a really small fraction in this entire world. And that complaining about rust on YouTube isn't really that important anymore. And I think that a lot of people sometimes need to reflect on stuff like this and just take a minute in a memorial park and reflect on their own lives. But if you're more interested in the Sexton, I will be uploading a walkaround video of this vehicle on my walkaround channel. So if you haven't subscribed yet, have a look. I hope you enjoyed this short little video. Let me know in the comments below if you ever heard about this piece of equipment before. I will see you in the next one.